Good morning students, my name is Poonam Daswani. I hope you all are good and your family is doing great. Students, today we will be starting with the math lesson 2, addition, my practice time 7. That is exercise 7. Math lesson 2, addition, my practice time 7. Students, I want you all to open your textbook. Page number 28. I want you all to open your textbook, page number 28, as well as open your notebook, new page. Math textbook, page number 28, and new page of your CW book. Students, as you can see in the textbook, there are questions given, but there is no space to solve the sums in the textbook. So today we will be solving the sums in the notebook. So I want you all to put today's date. I want you all to put today's date 28/7/20. That is 28 July 20. Right? Question 1. Estimate the sums to nearest tens by first rounding off the numbers. Now what we have to do? Estimate the sums. Estimate the sums means we have to add. Estimate the sum means we have to find the addition. Sum. Sum means total. So we have to add, but before adding, what we have to do? We have to change the numbers to nearest tens. First rounding of the numbers to nearest tens. Before adding, we have to change the numbers to nearest tens. First, we will find the numbers that are to nearest tens, and the nearest tens number that we get, we will add. I want you all to open your notebook, copy first question. You have to write my practice time 7, question 1. Estimate the sums to nearest tens by rounding off the numbers. I want you all to copy the question. By first rounding off the numbers to nearest tens. What is the first sum? That is A sum. 523 plus 154. Now what we will do before adding the two numbers, what we will do? First we will round off the numbers to nearest tens. First we will round off these numbers to nearest tens. You will write the answer. Rounding off the numbers to nearest tens, we get, when you round off the number 523, you get 520. When you round off the number 154, you get the number 150. I will show you in the notebook how to solve it. Students, this is the way how you're going to write in your notebook. You will put today's date 28/7/20, my practice time 7. You will write question 1, estimate the sums to nearest tens by first rounding off the numbers. We will round off these numbers first, then we will add. Now what you will do? You will round off the first number. When you round off the first number, what steps you follow? When you round off the number, what steps you follow? You will do it in the
rough work. You will not do it in the CW, but you will do it on a separate paper, rough work. So what we had to round off? We had to round off the number 523 to nearest tens. We had to round off the number to nearest tens. What is the number? 523. Now 3 comes under 1's place, 2 comes under 10's place, and 5 comes under 100's place. Whichever is the last number, we have to start writing from that number. So 1's, 10's, and 100's. So 3 comes under 1's place, 2 comes under 10's place, and 5 comes under 100's place. Now, when we round off the number to nearest tens, which number we see? We see the number on the ones place. We see the numbers on the ones place. Now, you have to see the number on the ones place. This number is smaller than 5 or this number is bigger than 5. You have to write the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and till 9 we will write. From 0 to 9. What we will do? We will write the numbers in one line. Now you have to see the numbers on the ones place. When we round off the numbers to nearest tens, we see the numbers on the ones place. Now we have to see this number whether it is bigger than 4, bigger than 5, or smaller than 5. Whether this number is bigger than 5 or this number is smaller than 5. So the 3 number is smaller than 5. Number 3 is smaller than 5. So what we will do? We will put a 0 here and we will not add any number here. So this 2 will remain same and this 5 will come down as it is. So when we round off the number 523 to nearest tens, what we get? We get 520. So what we get right? We will write the answer. We write the answer. Rounding off the numbers to nearest tens. What we get? Rounding off the numbers to nearest tens, we get, what we get? Now we rounded off the number 523. So what we got when we rounded off the number 523? What we got? We got 520. So you will write 520. Now which number we have to round off? The another number is 154. So we will do the rough work. 154. Now we will see the last number. We will write ones, tens, and hundreds. What we will do? We will write ones, tens, and hundreds. So 4 come under ones place, 5 come under tens place, 1 come under 100 place. Now when we round off the number to nearest tens, which number we see? We see the number on the ones place. We see the number on the ones place. We will see the number 4 is smaller than 5 or it is bigger than 5. So we will see the number 4. Number 4 is smaller than 5. So we will not add any number here. We will not add any number here. This number will become 0. This 5 will remain same and this 1 will also remain same. When we round off the number 154 to nearest tens, we get 150. So you got 150. Now what we will do? Now we have to add these two numbers. We have to add these two numbers. Why? Because we have to estimate the sum. Estimate the sum means we have to find the total. Now what you do? You will write 100, tens and ones. The first column we leave for the carry forward. So 520 plus 150. Now what you have to do? You have to arrange these numbers in the columns. So what we do? We will draw the columns. Now we draw the columns. We have to arrange these numbers in the columns. How you arrange these numbers in the columns, correct columns? What you do? You write ones, tens, hundreds. Here you write ones, tens and hundreds. So 520. 5 come under 1 place, 100 place, 2 come under 10 place, 0 come under 1's place. Here also same. 1 come under 100 place, 5 come under 10 place, 0 come under 1's place. Now what we will do? We add vertically in a standing line. Means we add the numbers on the 1's place, we add the numbers on the 10's place, we add the numbers on the 100's place. Now we add 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 means 0 means nothing. So 0 plus 0 is always 0. We add the numbers on the 10's place. What number is there on the 10's place? 2 plus 5. When you add 2 plus 5, you get 7. When you add 2 plus 5, you get 7. Now we add the numbers on the 100 place. How much is 5 plus 1? 5 plus 1 is 6. When you add these numbers, what is the sum you got? You got 670. So what we will write in the answer? What we will write in the answer? Thus, the estimated sum. What are we finding? Estimated sum. So what you will write? Thus, the estimated sum is what you got? 670. What you got? 670. Here what you write? Now, what are the numbers we got? 520 plus 150 is equal to, what is the number you got? This is the way you are going to solve the sum. Now we move on to the C sum. Now we move on to the C sum. What is the question on the C sum? +782. Now what we will do? 284 plus 782. You will write the answer. What you write? Rounding off the numbers to nearest tens, we get, now when you round off the number 284 and 782. Now, what you have to do? You have to do the rough work. What you have to do? You have to do the rough work. So, you will do it on the another page, separate paper, rough work. What you write? 284. Now, 4 come under 1's place, 8 come under 10's place, 2 come under 100 place, because we always start from the last number. We start from the last number 1's, 10's and 100's. Now what we do? When we round off the numbers to nearest tens, what we see? We see the number on the ones place. We see the numbers on the ones place. Now, the number on the ones place is 4. Now, 4 is less than 5 or bigger than 5? The number 4 is smaller than 5. The number 4 is smaller than 5. So what you do? You write 0 here and you will not add anything here. This number will remain as it is. The number on the 100 place will remain same. So when you round off the number 284 to nearest tens, you get 280. So you will write 280. Similarly, when you round off the number 782, what you do? Ones, tens, hundreds. Which number you will see now? You will see the number on the ones place. The number 2 is smaller than 5 or bigger than 5? It is smaller than 5. So we will not add any number here. This will remain 0. This 8 will this 2 will become 0. This 8 will remain as it is and this 7 will remain as it is. So when we round off the number 782 to nearest tens, we get 780. We get 780. Now, what you will write? Now, comma. What numbers you have got? You have got 270 and you got 280 and 780. Now, 280 plus 780. What you will do? You will add these two numbers. Now, for adding these two numbers, what we have to do? We have to arrange these numbers in the columns. Start arranging. How do you know which number comes under which column? So you will write 100, ones, tens and hundreds. Ones, tens, hundreds. Again in the second number also you will write ones, tens, hundreds. Ones, tens and hundreds. Now we have to draw the columns. Now what you will do? You will arrange these numbers in the correct columns. Now first number we leave for the carry forward. So 280 will come in this column. So we will write 280. 2 will come under 100 column, 8 will come under 10 column, 0 will come under 1 column. Don't forget to put the sign, which is the sign? Plus sign. So what is the another number? 780. Now we add vertically the numbers on the ones place, tens place, hundred place. What is the number on the one place? 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0. The number on the tens place is 8 plus 8. Now when you add 8 plus 8, you get 16. So you will write 6 down and 1 you will carry forward up. You will write 6 down and 1 you will carry forward up, because we write 16 like this, 1 and 6. So 6 will come down, 1 will come carry forward up. Now what we had to do, we had to add the numbers on the hundreds place. Now you will add 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 7 is 10. So you will write a 0 here, because we got the answer 10. And you will write one more column, that is thousands column. So the answer that we got is 1060. 1060. What is the answer you got? 1060. So what you will write? Thus, the estimated sum is how much? 1060. And you will underline it. Here also in the blank you will write. What is the answer you will write here? 1060. 1060. What answer you got? 1060. So you will write the answer here also. And you will write the answer here and you will underline. Now we move on to the next sum. Students, as the sums are similar of D, E, F, G, we move on to the H sum now. The sums D, E, F, G, I would want you all to do as the homework. Now we move on to the H sum. What is the question of the H sum? 2959 plus 1269. 2959 plus 1269. Now we write the answer. What we write? Rounding of the numbers to nearest tens, we get, what we get when we round off the numbers? What you will write? You will write 2959 and what is the another number? 1269. Now what we have to do? We have to round off these numbers. So you will do the rough work in a separate paper. Rough work. Now, as we have four numbers, how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Four numbers. So you will write from where you will start now? You will start from the last number, that is 9. What you will write? Ones, tens, hundreds and thousands, because there are four numbers. First we place the numbers in their correct place. So we are writing the place value. What is the place of 9? That is under ones. Place of value of 5 is under tens. Place value of 9 is hundreds. And place value of 2 is under thousands place. So we have arranged these numbers into their correct places. Now, for rounding off the numbers to nearest 10, what are we doing? Round off to nearest tens. Now, when we round off the numbers to nearest tens, which number we see? Which number we see? We see the numbers on the ones place. We see the numbers on the ones place. Now, write the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, Now what you have to do? The number 9 is smaller than 5 or it is bigger than 5. Everyone knows that the number 9 is bigger than number 5. So what we do? We write this number 0 on the ones place. We write it as 0. And because why we are writing it 0? Because in tens, when we round off to tens, there is 10. So we are writing here 10. In tens, there is 10. That's why we are writing 10 here. Now, as the number 9 is bigger than 5, what we do? We will add the number 1 here. We will add number 1 on the tens place. So 5 plus 1 is 6. This 9 will remain same and 2 will remain same. Are you getting, students? This 9 will become 0 because we are rounding off the numbers to nearest tens and 10 has 10 in it. So we round off it to 0. And as the number 9 is bigger than 5, we add one number here. So 5 plus 1 becomes 6. This 9 will remain same, 2 will remain same. Now the another number which we have to round off is 1269. Now again we will arrange these numbers in the proper place. What is the place of 9? In ones. Place of 6 is tens. Place of 2 is 100. Place of 1 is thousands. Now what we do? The another step is we see the number on the ones place. For rounding off to numbers 10, rounding off the numbers to nearest tens, what we do? We see the number on the ones place. Now number 9 is smaller than 5 or bigger than 5? The number 9 is bigger than 5. So what we do here? We will write a 0 here and we will add one number here. Because 10 contain how many 0? 10 contain 10. So we are rounding off to 10? Yes. So we have to make it 0 here. We have to write 10 here because in 10 there is 10. So we have to write 10 here because we are rounding off to nearest tens. So we convert it to 0. We add one number here because this number is bigger than 5. So 6 plus 1 is 7. 6 plus 1 is 7. This 2 will remain same. This 1 will remain same. When we round off this number to nearest tens, we get 1270. Now what are the two numbers which we got? We got 2960. We got 2960 and we got 1270. These are the two numbers we got after rounding off to nearest tens. Now what we have to do? We have to add these two numbers. So you will write now 2960 plus 1270. Why are we writing plus here? Because we had to estimate the sum. Sum means total. So for finding the total, we have to add is equal to and dash. Now what is the another step that we do? We will arrange these numbers in the columns to add. So you will write 1000, 100, tens and ones. thousands, hundred, tens, ones. Now we will arrange these numbers in the columns. This is the way how you are going to arrange the numbers in the columns. So we add vertically in a standing line. So when you add 0 plus 0, you get 0. 6 plus 7 is 13. When you add 6 plus 7, you get 13. Now 1 plus 9 is 10. 10 plus 2 is 12. So 2 you write down, 1 you carry forward up. Now 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 1 is 4. So what is the answer you got? 4230. So you will write 4230 and you will write, thus the estimated sum. What are we finding? Estimated sum is, what is the answer you got? 4230, and you will underline it. Students, I hope you all have understood the sum. The next question, that is question number 2. Question number 2 we will be continuing in the next lecture. I hope you all have understood the sums. We finished the question 1 of my practice time 2. So the another question we will solve in the next lecture. Thank you students for listening to the lecture. If you have any doubts or queries, you can mail it on my mail ID. You can check the sums and you will solve it as I have solved here, the sum B and the sum C. You can solve it in this manner, the sum D and sum E is also in the same manner. You have to round off it to the correct numbers, D and E, F and G, and the sum H and I. You have to round off the numbers in the correct manner and then you have to add the numbers. Students, if you have any doubts or queries, you can mail it on my mail ID. Thank you for listening to the lecture. Thank you so much.